Hi everyone, this is my BMW 320i with an M54 engine, and in this video series I will be changing the oil pan gasket, the oil filter housing gasket, and the valve cover gasket. Also, I will be doing the Venus rebuild, and I will change also the engine mounts and the tensioners pulleys. The videos will be a little bit long because I am trying here to show the maximum of the details. In this part one, I will be jacking up the car, flushing the engine, and removing some parts. First things first, let me introduce you my garage, that small space where I can barely move. There is no power supply, no compressed air, no lights, and it will be kind of challenge doing this work on that space, but it is doable. So to help jacking up the car, I am using here ramps that I built by myself using some piece of wood because my car is too low and it's got that sport suspension kit, which is a problem sometimes. In this project, I will be lifting the car only from the front, so the rear axle will be blocked with wheel chocks. Now I am starting removing that plastic cover. Always make sure to disconnect the battery before working on the engine. Look at this leakage. There is oil everywhere on the oil pan, on the front axle. Till now I was thinking that the oil pan was leaking, but surprise will be coming next. Now I will be lifting the car using that point under the subframe. Now I am locating that small car jack underneath the lifting point. And in between, I will be using a piece of wood. Now I am placing the car jacks underneath the front lifting points of the car. I'm doing here a final check. Now I have better access underneath the engine and time to remove the reinforcement plate. Now, time to warm up the engine. As the engine was warming up and to gain some time, I decided to remove some plastic parts. But if you are just flushing the engine, so ignore what I am doing here. Operating temperature is reaching. Stop the engine. Time to fill the oil flushing liquid. And one can from this product is useful for up to 6 liter engine oil. That's why I am going to use 1.5 of these cans, because the engine has a capacity of 6.5 liter engine oil. So if you are flushing a smaller engine, you can use only one can of these. Now, time to start the engine again and keep it running for 10 minutes. And again here, as the engine is running, I will use that time removing other parts. 10 minutes are up, time to drain the engine oil. and be prepared for spillages. Now give it a time to drain completely. I have a lot of time because I will be removing other parts. For the coming work on the engine, now I am removing the airbox. I was surprised here how the connection between the MAF sensor and the air boot was loose. Obviously, I forgot to tighten it as I changed the air filter the last time. You need 10mm socket to remove the airbox screws. Here I am putting the airbox together to protect the air filter because it is new. I already disconnected the fan. Now I am removing the fan. It is fixed on the top with two spots, one side with a screw and the other side with a clip. And give it a spin to check it out. In this part I will be removing the air boots or the air hoses. They are two pieces. One of them is connected to the MAF sensor and the other one is connected directly to the throttle body. And in between they are connected to each other with a clamp. And here I am using a silicone spray to remove that vacuum hose going to the fuel pressure regulator. And sorry for this bad camera view angle. Actually, I wasn't planning to post these videos on YouTube at the beginning. Removing that small vacuum line going to the jet pump and connected to the air intake boot wasn't easy. It was too hard to remove it. Always check these boots. They go bad very often. It is a common problem in BMWs and it was the case for me. It was cracked and I will change it. Diesel valve removal. It's got two screws. It should be also disconnected. I took off that protection sheet of the ABS system. Now I can easily remove the diesel valve. I am checking here the diesel valve if there is some plays, some damages. Remove the air boot connected to the throttle body. It's got two connections, one main connection to the throttle body and the second connection to the bypass valve. Take off the zip ties holding the power steering line. Now the engine oil should be completely drained. And time to get rid of the old oil. Fill it on a safe container and think about the environment. I am putting here the drain screw back in place. This part one ends here, and the next video will be the part two, removing the belts, the pulleys, the alternator, and the oil filter housing. For more details about these videos, please refer to the description below. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.